Thank you. that complexity. It's really cool because all of this complexity was exploded inside the genre.
In a restless search for new opportunities and new ways of living, the mystery and the promise of distant horizons always have called men forward.
Echo. Doctor. Thank you. Thank you. Down, hear the sound of his brow. You look down.
Oh.
Vegetable Man.
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 Oh, he's the kind of fella you just gotta see if you can.
Vegetable Man.
Let's roll another one. Deeply unsuitable. And then finally, Vegetable Man, which is an extraordinary little, just a little sort of portrait, really, of Sid. Big thing was that Sid never finished writing it, so we never finished recording it, which meant it never actually got released. And so, in fact, we think that it was never played by Pink Floyd, or by Roger, or by David, or by any of the tribute bands. So we think this is our special offering. And it's probably a very good moment just to recognise Sid, because he was the guy that got me to us.
If I go insane, understand the spaces between friends.
Sydney is the most important city in the world. And we're going to take a minute now and do a song to remember the late, great Richard Wright. And this is a song that is all about looking back to when you're a child, which is what I've been doing since I got up, because it's 41 years, nearly to the day, that I was first flown down here to play for Ice House. And so my whole mad life in music started. I only really found my old flat in Bondi Beach today. It's very, very emotional. And I usually dedicate this song to my son Stanley, because Rick was his granddad. But tonight I want to dedicate it to a man to whom I owe an inestimable debt of gratitude. I'm thrilled that he's here tonight with his son Evan. This is for you, Ivor Davis.
Thank you.
He very wisely didn't contact me to discuss it because I didn't know him at the time. And he went to Guy, who thought it was a good idea and that sounded promising. So we arranged a meeting, the three of us, which Guy arrived at. By the time Guy arrived, we'd actually already agreed that we were going to give it a go. So that is Mr. Lee Harris on guitar and vocals. Then we have a remarkable man on the keyboards. I did count up that there were 300 keys for him to choose from, plus lots of buttons and dials and things to twist and so on. But his experience with the organ, first of all, means that he can stay up for 14 hours playing music. But also that actually, I think the organ had a single, a hit single, that was 44 minutes long. Now, I think Pink Floyd know about long tracks, but I have to say, in this example, respect. And that is Mr. Don Beekman, keyboards and vocals. And then a man I've known for well over 30 years, and trust implicitly in his judgment on music, and so as I say, he played a part in putting this thing together as well, in fact. And that, of course, is Mr. Guy Pratt on bass guitar and vocals. And then we have our very own version of A Star Is Born. A man who came from being an very successful new romantic into being an absolute blinding prog rock god. And that is Mr. Gary Kemp, guitar and vocals.
Thank you. Yes, I am extremely honoured to be on this stage. 50 years ago, you and I bought records we thought were the best things we'd ever heard. 50 years later, we know they were the greatest records ever made. And someone who's helped to give us that eternal pleasure is on stage. He's on drums, Mr. Nick Mason.
Of the evening, and what I'll tell you now is that we intend to do the song and then we're going to take a short break. But this song features something, this magnificent gong that I had to watch Roger Waters playing for years. And excuse me, sorry, I did say you could use your phones, but. Hello? Roger, hi. No, not busy. Holiday. Yeah, Brighton. No, I think we've been through this a number of times now, I haven't seen your gong. I've no idea where it is. I said before, we should, I think maybe David's got it. Yeah. Yes. Yes. Okay. Thank you. No, I am busy, actually. Okay. Fine. Sorry about that.
Thank you. the second sea, the light between the blue you once knew. Floating down the sands and around the icy waters underground. Return of Saturn, over wonder and around Titania.
Yeah.
one. I always wanted to sing that song. It was the first Pink Floyd song I knew, so I thought they were a heavy metal band. Because it was on the album that everyone had back at school, which was Relics, which of course had a fabulous cover by Nick Mason. Yeah, that's not where everyone had it. Everyone had it because it was half the price of all the other Pink Floyd records. I thought back in 2006 I might get a chance to do this one when we were getting ready for David Gilmour's tour. David very kindly asked us if we had suggestions to put in the set. And I suggested we could play the Nars song, and he suggested I could perhaps play for another band. So now I do. This is another one from Obscured by Clouds. This is called Burning Bridges.
just to sleep. Push all the cold chips and rest. All those fruits in your tears. You will wake with a start. Just the beating of your heart. Just want a man beneath the sky. Just two kills and just right. Sail across the seas of long lost hopes and memories. Childhood's and your fantasy, only true harsh reality. Away as the Satan's voice, find your eyes from the cause. All the fears never force, so you gotta make the final choice.
It was green fields, but I've always been embraced. Lovely to be here, isn't it, Guy? Beautiful. Does anyone know? Actually, they do know, because I heard someone shout it out earlier. We have a podcast, Guy and I, called The Rockonteurs. And if you don't know, you can tune into it. It's on all the platforms, and we basically chat about rock, and we have a different rock artist on pretty much every week, don't we?
We do.
Nick has been on.
Nick Mason, we've had on. Brian Johnson.
Carverdale, Alice Cooper,
Andy McCluskey, Jim Kerr,
no, who?
Joe Elliott, yes.
Joe Elliott, yeah. Sheryl Crow. They've all been on. We've got 100 and something on.
70.
170. And when we come to venues, it's quite good. You get sort of ideas as to who's on. You know, you see people wearing t-shirts in the audience, like In Excess, I saw, and
Ice House, probably.
Ice House, yeah.
The Church, the Saints, Hunters and Connections,
Midnight Oil. Yeah, they're all there. There's a Jeffrey Tull wearer as well. But what I don't see are any fucking Spandau Ballet t-shirts. Yeah, I know, you're wearing them spiritually. Okay, this is one about a cat.
Thank you.
the blood one thing.
I've got a cloak, it's a bit of a joke. It's got a tail on the front, it's red and black. I've had it 4 months. If you think it could look good, then I guess it should.
You're the kind of girl fits in with my role. I'll give you anything, everything if you want this.
And he hasn't got a house. I don't know why I call him Gerald. He's getting rather old, but he's a good mouse.
You're the kind of girl fits in with my world. I'll give you anything, anything if you want things.
I've got a clan of gingerbread men. Here are men, there are men. Lots of gingerbread men. Take a couple if you wish, they're on the dish.
Most of them are clockwork. Let's go into the other room.
And make it work.
Thank you!
Okay, it's a tradition now. You've got a video of us, I get a video of you. Paul, have you got a light so we can see what they look like?
Ooh!
Okay. Gotta give you a few share now. Can you tell you what, if you're in the balcony, put your phone lights on. Guy won't kill you. Yet. That's loads of them, brilliant. 3, 2, 1, give me share.
Good.